forest, next to a hill, lived a bear. The bear had many friends, squirrels, rabbits, bees, songbirds of every color, fox, deer, and more. But he was restless. He felt there had to be more to life than raiding the hives of bees for their honey, eating berries and apples, and growing fatter and fatter until it was time to sleep again. He wanted to expand his horizon, so he decided to climb to the top of the hill. Why? Well, you know why. To see what he could see. At first, all of his friends tried to talk him out of it, but not the owl, who wisely advises him to go explore and learn.
Year after year. I'm gonna try something new for once. I'm gonna get out here.
Well, why don't you go on a little trip to shake off your hibernation? What you really need is a little spring vacation.
Great idea! I know just where to go. Up that mountain there. I always want to see the top and breathe the mountain air.
Up that mountain, you can't be serious. No one has ever gone there. It's not a good place to tramp from any hair or bear.
Well, I'm going. Anyone can come along.
And what if I find that mountain? You better sing a mountain song.
Oh,
I've seen. It's everywhere.
I feel like we're being followed. Everyone better beware.
Look, I saw something moving over there and there and there.
The creature is something that will catch it unaware.
Come on, son of a bitch!
above us and the clouds are down below.
Thank you.
see that this trip I made with all of you has made the bear me.
Next time you have a dream that scales all up, you have all kinds of friends now and we'll be here to help.
Whoa, wonderful adventure. I made up the mountain.
Now it's all gone.
Look at the big smile on Mrs. Leonard's face. Why do you think it's there? What do you think?
Because we did a good job.
You did a fantastic job. Boys and girls, your hard work and your sense of team play really showed this morning. You did such a wonderful job, and you should be very proud of your efforts. I know the folks in the audience were so entertained. So you need to know that you have worked really hard, and you have been so successful this morning. I couldn't be more proud of you. Okay, parents and guests, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Before I go any further, I would like to introduce to you this lady, a young lady at my side. I'd like you to meet Principal Callie Mayer. She has taken over my job for today. Each fall at the family picnic, I offer an auction package principal for the day. So Callie's parents were the high bidder on that package this year. So today is her day to take over my role, give me a little bit of rest and relaxation, and she can see what it's all about. So, Principal Callie, do you have anything you would like to say to the children?
Absolutely. I think, boys and girls, you did an amazing job.
See? Everybody! That shared their talents and time and energy with the children so they could have the show, the successful show that they did this morning, and I'd like to acknowledge those folks. First, we have some members from Mrs. Dunn's 5th grade technical theater class. I believe the only person here is Catherine in the back. Ken Boswell is operating the boards. Hello is our scenic artist. The costumes, I think you'll agree with me, are absolutely adorable. They're the handiwork of Marilyn Watts. Gail Palmer choreographed the dance number and worked with the children. She had to leave, but a thank you to Miss Palmer. And then I want to thank, home with the baby right now, but Mrs. Florio, she got the process started with the children. Thank you to Mrs. Florio, to Mrs. Wallace, who was on stage supporting the children's efforts. And a huge thank you to Mrs. Sanders, who came all the way back from Kentucky to take over. And Mrs. Sanders' aide is Lisa Hackwood in the back. The technical director is Danny Higgins Dunn, who did the delightful introduction. And last but not least, and the second shining star this morning, the children's music teacher and the director of the show, Karenna Montani. This is Ms. Montani's first year at Parker, but she's definitely taken the campus by storm. She's doing an amazing job, and the children are so fortunate to have her for their teacher. So thank you, Ms. Montani. To you, star performers, you've warmed our hearts this morning with your singing, with your dancing, with your acting, with your beautiful smiles. You couldn't have made our day any happier than you did. So I say, parents and guests, one last round of applause for our first performers.
Oh, no.